In a full subtractor, we have three bits, A, B and borrow in. And then we do have difference and borrow. Right? So this is very similar to a full adder where we have AB and the carry in. And then we have the sum and carry out. So since there are three inputs, you have A combination 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Now since we need to find the difference in borrow here, in this case, we have to very carefully enter and fill in the truth table. Now 0 minus 0 minus 0, difference is 0, borrow is 0, that's very simple. So to identify the difference and borrow, let us consider two bits at a time. So I have 0, 0 here. So 0 minus 0 will give me 0 itself, right? It's going to give me 0 minus 1. So when I have 0 minus 1, I need a borrow and there will be a difference. As we have seen when we enter the truth table for a half subtractor. So when I borrow 1, this becomes 1, 0. So you have 1, 0 is nothing but 2 in decimal. 2 minus 1, difference is 1. So what do we get? We get 1, 1. Next. 0 minus 1. So I have 0 minus 1. So therefore, definitely I have a borrow and a difference. Okay, so there is a borrow. So I will enter 1. And then 1 minus 0. The difference is retained. Next, 0 minus 1 minus 1. So 0 minus 1, I have a borrow of 1. Okay, so I will get 1 here, but then I have minus 1 again here. So 1 minus 1, difference is 0. So I get a 0 here. Right? So if we consider two bits at a time, find the intermediate result and then subtract the next bit, we will not make mistakes while entering the difference in borrow. Next, 1, 0, 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1, minus 0 is 1. So difference is 1, there is no borrow, so I get 1, 0. Next, 1 minus 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1, and then I have minus 1, so I get a 0 here, right? So we end up getting 0 and 0. Next, 1 minus 1 is 0, minus 0 is again 0, so there is no difference and there is no borrow. Next, 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1 is 0 and then minus 1. So 0 minus 1, definitely I need a borrow. I will get a difference 1. So I get 1, 1. So this is the truth table for a full subtractor. Okay. So the easiest way to fill in the difference and the borrow column is to consider two bits at a time. Identify the difference and borrow. And then subtract the third bit and we will finally be able to identify the borrow and difference for the three bits being considered. Right? So this is as far as the truth table is concerned. So now we need to write the expression. We need to write the expression for difference and borrow. So how do we write the expression? We need to write the simplified expression. So let us try to simplify it using KMAP, a three variable KMAP. Right? So there you have A, B, B in. So 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Okay? So what are the values? The values are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is for difference. So now let me enter the values there. For 0 it is 0, for 1 it is 1, 2, 3. So 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So for 4 is 1, for 5 is 0, for 6 is 0, and then 7 is 1. Right? So this is the expression for difference. So there is no way by which we can reduce the expression for difference. So therefore the expression for difference would be in bar, yes. So this is A, B bar, B in bar, plus A bar, B in, plus A bar, B in bar, plus A, B in, right? So I missed out the complement, to write the complement for B in bar. So this is the expression for difference. So now let us see if we can simplify the expression for borrow. So now the expression for borrow. So let me fill in the terms. For 0 is 0. For 1, 2, 3. And then you have 0, 0, 0, 1. 0, 0, 0 and 1. So definitely these two can be combined. These two pairs can be combined. These two pairs can be combined. So when I combine these two pairs, what is the expression? So you have A bar. Okay. B gets cancelled because it is complementary 0, 1. So I get B in. Plus, for this, A gets cancelled because A is complementary. So we have B into B in. Plus, the expression here for this pair would be A bar into B. So this is the expression for both. Right? So A bar B in plus A bar B plus B into B in. So let me write the expression here. A bar B in plus A bar B plus B into B in. Right? So once I get the expression for difference and borrow, this can be implemented using gates. Using NAND gates as well as using NOR gates. Okay, so I guess you are well aware as to how these expressions can be implemented using NAND and NOR gates. So how do I implement this using NAND gates? Double complement the expression, convert sum to product. Okay, how do we implement these two expressions using NOR gates? Double complement both the expressions and convert all products to sum and then implement the expression. Okay, so that would be very simple since we have already done the implementation for a half adder, for a full adder and for a half subtractor. I guess you are very well aware as to how these two expressions can be implemented using both NAND gates and NOR gates only. Right, so this is a full subtractor. So what is important here is, in a full subtractor, we need to fill in the truth table correctly. So how do I fill in the truth table correctly? Consider two bits at a time, subtract these two bits, right? And then consider the intermediate result and then subtract the third bit and you will get the value of difference and borrow.